Oh yeah, I definitely would not be able to do that kind of choreography. All right, what's going on, everyone? Welcome to another episode of Reacting to Stuff. This is a new segment of Emeroy TV. I'm probably going to release this before the actual episode one because it's kind of like trending right now. It just came out like a week ago.
No. Is it? Oh yeah, it came out on Friday, last Friday, the 22nd.
So yeah, so today, as you can see, we have a special. So today, as you can see, we have a special guest, Maxine. You've seen her on my special Awkward Tea Party episodes here on the channel. So she's back. What makes me excited is that I've been wanting to do a video content with her for a while, and she made it happen with the new hair. So
with the new hair, with my free makeup. Thanks, CoverGirl.
So today we're going to be reacting to everything Rain on Me. So
I will, quick disclaimer, I've seen the music video like about 15 times already. I know this video inside and out. I just wanted to see, his reaction. I just wanted to see him react to things.
Did you? So let's jump into the video. I love songs that start off like this. It just starts so strong. I never asked for the rainfall. At least I showed up. You showed me nothing at all. Oh, I never realized those were knives.
Yeah.
I love the color scheme.
This is a good intro to the album.
Oh, I love that. It's more like jazz funk. That was fun. Choreography is a lot of fun. Ooh, okay, I like that little side to side. This is my second time watching this. Wait a second. Oh no, never mind. I thought that was All My Friends.
Oh my gosh.
I thought it was my friend Daniel Diaz. I love the transitions. It's fun.
Oh, the.
Yeah, the flipping happening. Oh,
I love that.
Oh, I like that movement. That's a fun.
Oh, okay. The table.
I really like this. Is like one, this move right here. The... Yeah.
Sailor Moon vibes.
Is it?
I don't know.
Like yeah. When I first watched this, I love that. I love that. This is actually how I used to dance in clubs. My hat's up.
I love this.
I like these rotating formations. Man, these outfits are fucking sick, man. But they dance
was
a certain
that
way.
Single ladies.
Yeah, it really was. It was a little bit of that single ladies. I feel like that's kind of a recall with their own twist on it. Dude, I love the outfits. The outfits
they look
are
like
sick.
Sisters. And it's not because they're both Italian American.
Ariana Grande's Italian?
Yes.
Oh.
Her actual last name is Butera. Ariana Grande Butera.
Oh, dang. I thought she was Hispanic.
She's Italian. Yeah. No, she's very tan Italian.
Yeah, so overall, like, I think it's fun. The song is super. It feels, like, very housey. Something I would definitely do a lot of, like, house freestyling to. Maybe even, I actually would love to hear that in a jam. I could potentially see people whacking to it.
Ooh,
I love the the outfits. Again, I don't do like the costumes in my company because I suck shit at that. But I love the outfits because that wardrobe, man, would definitely have been fun. And one thing I was thinking throughout the whole video is like, damn, this music video is hype, but a lot of what you're doing on set is really just standing around waiting for the crew to get ready and then doing the shots again and again.
Does remind me just a little bit of how K-pop music videos are kind of structured. It's a little bit simpler, but like, you know, just visually, like dancers behind you, choreography that's kind of easy to follow, their repetitive choreography, costumes that are over the top,
yeah,
colors,
yeah,
like color schemes, and it's very, you know, like each shot has its own kind of color scheme. Like Ariana's kind of the purple, Lady Gaga's kind of the pink.
Yeah,
and
you're right.
Shot of her with the head thingy or whatever, and yeah, it's, you know, like a magenta-y,
yeah,
kind of color scheme. And then even the previous video, Stupid Love was all pink.
Yeah,
I mean the outfits were all pink. Like it was like all pink, and it was like this like green screen desert.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I definitely would not be able to do that kind of choreography.
That graphic liner. Oh.
Oh, what they're doing? Oh, I just barely noticed
eyeliner.
That.
Eyeliner. What?
This little switch up right here.
Oh.
So they're doing another set, and then they're doing another set. Or they're kind of just switching through.
Yeah,
I love that groove.
There's a lot of close-ups.
Yeah. It's a nice basic cruise right there. Man,
and
she's dancing on, and fuck it, they're dancing on platforms?
Yeah.
Fuck, dude.
Lady Gaga used to heavily perform in go-go boots before, when she was performing in the in bars on the Lower East Side. Ariana Grande needs the heels because she's a fellow short person.
That's a simple, fun one that that people are probably gonna be doing. This is fun.
Oh yeah, it's already all over TikTok.
Is it really? Ah, of course.
And they're not doing the choreo. I think they borrowed elements of the choreo from the music video, but I think they've been coming for their own.
This is fun.
Yeah, and this is like how Lady Gaga is just like changing and adapting to the times, because like most pop stars now are wearing this kind of outfit, like, you know, the kind of bondage-y kind of outfits, like drag queens are doing it, pop stars are doing it, and then, you know, someone, you know, there was like a meme that was like
really, I don't know anything about that, like the whole bondage-y look.
Yeah, corset, like a lot of like pleather or leather, the collars, the harnesses.
Oh,
it's kind of like, yeah,
sorry, I thought of people being roped up and tied.
That's not the only kind of, oh my god.
So the next one we're going to watch is a video editor reacts to Lady Gaga. What happened? Oops.
There's a dude right behind him.
I know. I like that there's a time code literally right under his fucking...
Oh my god.
I mean, he's a video editor.
Yeah.
That's an aesthetic.
Yeah.
The cool thing about this opening shot is... in the camera move, we tell an entire story. We start with the face, and then the camera booms up, and we reveal that there's a knife.
Let me see what you have.
I
know it. Like,
oh, shoot. I have to know how this happened, and boom.
Yeah.
Right away, we're hooked. We're engaged.
That was a good way of,
a knife.
Of hooks,
like
getting,
Robert
in the, getting them hooked.
Lita, Battle Angels, Spy Kids.
I love Spy Kids.
I know. I never saw it. Okay, stop.
I've never seen Spy
Kids
either.
Oh, frick, he directed Machete. That's crazy. I edited Danny Trejo, which is one of the stars. He did Shark Boy and Lava Girl.
I saw that.
Basically, this guy's a boss. I've never seen any of his work because I was deprived as a child. But let's check
That's
out.
That's so rude. I love Spy Kids.
So the song's called Rain on Me, and we have rain coming down. But the ring is full of
knives.
And that's,
yeah, that's
how she gets stabbed right here. We have a knife that comes down right into her freaking leg. Imagine that. That would freaking hurt. Dang.
That's going to be next in after COVID.
Raining knives. That's what's coming in June. Because the full album comes out this Friday on the 29th.
Oh, does it really?
Ooh. Yes.
She's such a good performer, man.
Oh. Yo! That's so good. That is so good.
Amazing, show-stopping, spectacular, never the
we
same.
All know I had to.
Breakdown section when it went into the pre-chorus, holy frick. So here's the thing. I love K-pop videos. If
Me
you
too.
Can't tell already, go watch some of my other videos right over here. This
Wait, really?
Is like a K-pop video. Hmm. We have the dancers.
That's for another
we
episode.
We have the sets. We have the costumes.
Yeah.
It's a good freaking time.
It's really like
nice
over the top. It's crazy.
My favorite part.
I think what I love about the okay, so I'm just like adding my thing now. Just thoughts are coming as we watch this. Like,
it's not mostly him.
Yeah, and like what I love about the choreography mm-hmm. is like how big the shapes are. Because a lot of coming from the competitive community, a lot of the moves get super intricate and really fast. Like da 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 da. And then sometimes, and for regular people, that's hard to see. But dancers can appreciate that. But for regular people, like the big movements, is mm-hmm. what makes it super entertaining. Like what I love here is like is the strong silhouettes.
That's we have.
So,
yes.
Spectacular.
Or is it that? So we're not watching the direct. Yeah. So these strong shapes are so distinct, especially mm-hmm. with the leans and the reaches
and
the switches.
The movement is just like super simple. It's not intricate, but it looks great.
That this is what like one of the type
it
of choreography.
It takes a visual space.
That's
a good
what
way.
This is the type of choreography I love because it doesn't have to do a lot to entertain. It's like the whole mm-hmm. less is more aspect, like really capturing the essence of the song instead of trying to catch every beat of the song.
Yeah.
Yes.
So again, look at those silhouettes. Yeah, I love that.
Yo,
and that's what most of voguing and whacking is. I mean, whacking is a little bit more. There's a lot going on with whacking, but it's all shapes.
When it went into the pre-chorus,
yeah, like
and like silhouettes.
Even with the feet, you can see the silhouettes.
Mm-hmm.
And then when the beat drops, we have this cool transition where the whole world turns upside
down. I love that
I love
transition,
that part.
Though.
Whip pan up, and it's the knives falling down. And mm-hmm. it's like the knives are the rain.
According
to L.com, it's like this song is about Lady Gaga.
I don't know how I would feel about that.
Called out, like, hey, you're doing these things that hurt me. And as humans, we hurt each other constantly. That's just part of human nature. And this song is about celebrating the fact that we can come together and we can talk about our differences, talk about how we've been hurt, and have our friendship blossom because of it. The knives here, I think, represent the hurt that comes down when we talk about our differences and talk about what has hurt us before, but we still survive because of it. We have a knife in our leg, but we're still dancing.
I love how deep he got within the first minute of the music video.
And then
like life lesson right here. But strong silhouettes.
Man, dancing is so fun.
Yeah, it is fun.
Oh, she takes out the knife.
I fucking love that little bounce. It feels very housey.
Very, and like the choreo itself, like how she's doing it.
See
is,
those fast cuts right there? The
okay,
best
well,
place
let
to
him
put
speak.
Fast, ooh, right there? You see those fast cuts right there? The best place to put fast cuts is where a musical fill could happen. I'm a drummer, and so I am attuned to when fills would happen in music, beatbox through this section of the song, and I'll put a fill where the fast cuts happen. So those cuts kind of created a visual fill where there would normally be a fill in music.
Are you picking up tips?
I love this video so far, and nothing against Robert Rodriguez, but I think I would cut this a little bit differently. I have a feeling
I think every
that
editor would.
Ariana's verse was affected by the label and affected by notes maybe from her management or something. There are a ton of close-ups in her verse, and I'd rather see more of a wide shot.
Yeah.
I have a feeling that they wanted to see her face up close so we can recognize her and feel more connected to her. But there
so
are
with the close-ups, there's a lot of close-ups on here in the video, like for both of them.
Yeah.
My thing with the close-ups are, it's also basically a commercial for Lady Gaga's makeup line.
Oh, is it really? Oh, this is all like done with Lady Gaga's makeup?
Yes.
Oh.
A bunch of jump cuts.
House Labs.
I'm not a really big fan of it.
Yeah, I feel the same way with all these jump cuts.
connected to her.
Not
but
really.
There are a lot of just similar framings that are cut together, and it kind of feels like a bunch of jump cuts.
Yeah.
And I'm not a really big fan of it. I also don't like that we use this shot as the first shot that we see Ariana. I feel like the note was given that we don't see Ariana early enough in the song, so they had to put the shot in here. But I would much rather wait to see her until her verse and come in on like a nice wide shot, so she has more of like a grand reveal, like
like a wide shot at again.
Yeah, because it's gonna be like epic seeing all those other people instead of just like a close up.
Like everyone there.
The focus.
And then,
yeah, the focus is on her, and then she's
eventually gonna push into her anyway.
Yeah, so because that's how I felt with seeing Lady Gaga's shot. It felt like I was seeing her like and her crew. I love the outfit changes
cool.
Between
so they do the same spin transition, but this one's really cool because we have both of the artists in here. In one version, they're wearing a lighter outfit, and then another version, they're wearing the darker outfit. And it's super cool to see a reflection, but the images actually don't match.
Look too. It's just as we're watching this, like I love when we do like random pauses in performances, because then you could see like the cleanliness of the dancers, and it's like 95% there. Even the small leg placements. This is something I used to do with fam. Is like when we'd watch some our replay videos. This is way back. We'd watch the tape, but obviously we'd do random pauses. And if you see the random someone like randomly off, you see what's not clean. So just even then, like look what's happening here. I'd say it's pretty
really cool,
super clean. It makes me wonder how much cleaning they did.
Oh yeah.
And we spin back. Ooh.
I love the grooves.
This is what I'm talking about. That's what I wanted to see. So we get in the bridge section and we're in an entirely new location. I have no idea what's going on. There's a bunch of tubes connected to Lady Gaga. It looks like she's like on life support or something.
She's the adjutant
for
StarCraft 2.
This is what I wanted for Ariana's verse. I wanted to see the entire new location for her verse. And then maybe when we go to the chorus, we can see them together. But this is what we got.
See, I'm about to fly.
That's what I
want. Okay, stop the. Yo, what did I just watch? There's little people down here. Yeah. Is she like controlling everything?
Yes.
Is everything like connected? Because
she's part
to
of the Illuminati.
Because she's Lady Gaga.
That was crazy. I don't know. It was art though, and I loved it. But like, there's so much to dissect in that bridge. I have no idea what's going on. I wish there was like that throughout the entire video. That was really, really interesting. What I do love is how when it went to this underwater feel, the visuals look like we're underwater. So we have like her in this like life support thing, and then we have this hair moving, and it kind of looks like the hair is underwater. All of it is a really cool concept, and there's so many.
It's getting anime vibes.
I don't even know where to start.
Yeah.
Put an overlay of like freaking Sakura petals on there.
What I really would have loved with this scene, I'm pretty sure this little rotating formation, I would have loved to see a wide and then slow and then push into them, because visually in formations that would have been sick.
The rotating a wide shot, but like on level with them, not the overhead.
No, the overhead.
A wider shot
of the overhead, because then you would see because you see people going in different directions. Mm-hmm. So
that would have been so good.
It would have been dope to see it overhead.
You know what that looks good at? Like a kind of formation like that. So in in the musical Hamilton.
Uh-huh.
So you and I have seen the bootlegs.
Yeah.
From someone filming from the balcony.
Yeah.
So what we were seeing is like literally kind of like a overhead like kind of shot of it.
Yeah.
So we're seeing like we're seeing how they utilize a big turntable and how they do their choreography, especially for Helpless.
Yeah.
With it, because the reverse thing happens on there too. Like you can actually see that, and then compare it to when I saw it. I was down in orchestra. Flex. I was down in orchestra. And I was just kind of seeing it like straight up, and I'm like, I wasn't able to appreciate it as much, but I liked how it looked like from someone who used to be on stage. Like I'm like, oh my God, that blocking is amazing. Seeing it from up top.
Yeah. And like now coming from like a competitive, but also like where formations were a huge part of my life for like in dance. So seeing the formation rotate, a huge part of what we used to do before we did any close-ups for any you know, in these dance videos, a lot of the dance videos we used to prefer watching was wide shots. Because then you would see the different formations happening. Because the blocking for dancing is huge alongside mm-hmm. with the choreography, and being able to, you know, make it blend together is dope, which is one of the reasons I love the K-pop rehearsals videos so much.
Because it's all wide.
Because it's wide and you see all the formation changes and it's seamless. And then when there's visuals, like with this, I would have loved to see the visual of the whatever was the rotating formation and then push to them. Because I feel like that this whole visual would have hit mm-hmm. better if we see the wide and push to them. But I'm guessing they probably went straight to that, maybe because there wasn't enough time for it to really land, or maybe it just didn't look as good. But
it was a label note. I don't know.
I would have liked that. Yeah, because, you know, if the label just wanted to see them and not the dancers.
Yeah.
The VFX are on point, man.
Look at those sisters.
That's so good, man. I love this setup, and in my humble opinion, they should have ended the video with this shot.
I agree.
Yep, I agree. Yeah.
But instead, they show this smiling shot at the end, which is great. It's like it's a feel-good thing, but it's such a different emotion from the previous shot that we just saw that it kind of takes me out of it. I feel like this shot was maybe one of those notes that came from Ariana's label where they were like, oh, we have to see Ariana and Lady Gaga together smiling at the end. Like, that has to be the final image. And so we put it in there, but I think the music video would have been better off if we ended on that last rain.
Yeah, I almost feel like that quick smile shot that they did could have been done in the midst of like the dance sequence.
In the midst of like the dancing, because like I've seen music videos do that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've seen music videos do that. They'll do like an outtake, like they'll squeeze it in there.
Yeah, because then
because it's cute and fun.
It would be a quick boom, like a quick beat, cut back to the dancing, and then finish it with Lady Gaga. Boom. I agree with that. Should have been. Okay. Let's do like one more reaction video. What else?
Okay.
All right. You want to do the vocal coach one?
Is that Tristan Paredes?
Yeah. Let's do it. So I'm gonna grab
this. I like Tristan Paredes.
Yo, what's good, Tristan's and Trist fam? Today we've got Lady Gaga, Ariana Grande, Rain On Me music video.
Cute. Queen Kitty. So neither of us are singers, so we don't really have
a quick listen.
None of us
continue listening, but I love them because I have to save my reactions for these videos. But I am beyond excited to jump into this video. I know this is gonna be a good one, just on this outfit.
This establishing shot was pretty intense. I only asked you to show me a real good time. What I liked about that shot, it was like it catches the attention, especially with the bright colors, but when you pull out it creates curiosity with the knife, like what the previous editor said, but also the amount of negative space around it creates the feeling of being alone.
What else was there? That too.
Yo, this is so different, dude. This is such a different sounding song so far for anything Gaga or Ariana Grande, or just in general, that is like coming out.
People are gonna hate me because I really don't know the difference of like the different sounds. So
It doesn't sound like anything that's coming out right now.
Yeah, that's true. It's honestly refreshing compared to like the stuff I've been listening to, because I listen to Spotify like top 40 just to like keep my ear out on what's happening, and you know, you never know if they're gonna throw down in a jam.
No, this reminds me of like some old Ariana actually. So
I love that.
Actually, yeah.
I wonder if they're gonna sing harmony together, because their voices actually sound very. They're very contrasting, aren't they? They're two very different styles of vocals, and they
super breathy, and then
Grande's
just
voice is simultaneously lighter than Gaga's, which is more say more of a powerhouse belting type of a thing, whereas Ariana Grande's voice is more mixy and tends to like blend more and be sort of light and airy maybe, whereas Gaga's is almost just like
I love the samples happening
ways,
right now.
Her voice is like in Broadway. That's why.
Damn, she is such a good performer, man.
This is showing what I'm talking about.
That energy.
That's like kind of where
Ariana is. Excuse you. Green. So what?
so I don't lose what? My mind. It's like breathy.
That guy.
It's light, it's airy, but it's like slightly darkened by this.
He did the Ariana.
So I don't lose my mind. Or whatever.
Or whatever.
And whereas Gaga's out here just belting, it's coming down on me. That was so interesting. I
don't know why
think that their little duet section would sound like that with Gaga in this like very low part of her voice. She's almost like in her voice.
Oh, you were listening to this the other day.
Let's see.
That's right.
What?
You were watching this the other day.
Yeah.
I'll be your galaxy. I'm about to fly.
Vocal fry.
That's exactly what she's doing.
I learned a little bit from her.
So Gaga, in order to get into this part of her voice, she's kind of here, and then, you know when you wake up in the morning, you just kind of like this, and then you kind of, like, do a little bit more into it.
So that's what the girl from, The Grudge is doing. She's vocal frying you. I'm like, no, my ears.
I'm about to fly. It sounds really cool, actually, with Ariana Grande.
For some reason, I thought this said Chipotle. The thing
it's
on the Chromatica. Bottom left.
That's her album.
Shit.
Chipotle coming May 29th.
It sounds really cool. That's actually, clever. With Ariana Grande like hitting the high notes at the same time that Gaga's doing this. It's such a weird contrast, actually.
That is really cool. It's not what I was expecting when I first watched it. It's a lot of bouncing.
Mm-hmm. I mean, it's.
This dancing is so fabulous, dude. Dude, heck yes. This was actually kind of different. And everything about this is different. The music video is different. The song is kind of weird and different. But, like, I'm definitely 100%
I love
here
it.
For it.
Anyway,
I enjoyed the video. I really like this song. And I'm excited to see.
Yeah. I mean, I think overall, I love seeing the different perspective. I hope you guys seeing the perspective of us. My perspective of being a professional dancer, and then seeing the video editor, and then seeing vocal coach. So seeing different perspectives. Hope you guys enjoyed. You have anything you want to add before we go?
I just love Lady Gaga.
So she's a great performer. She is fun to watch. She commands the stage. Like even just watching her, and that small like the small snippet of him saying like how she's Broadway. Like in that performance, man, I feel that energy, and I think that's one thing. I think a lot of performers or dancers need to work on, or it's an important skill to develop. But that's a skill you only develop through experience and being on stage, which is.
And
you
she's
have,
been on stage for a long time.
She clearly has experience, and she's. I feel like she's gotten like the proper like mentorship or guidance.
She went to Tish.
Yeah, so it's like. Because you can perform on stage for a long time, but if you don't get the feedback, if you don't get guidance in becoming a better performer, you know, you might just end up being stuck. So it's not just performing, but it's also getting the feedback and then keep building on that. So, and I've had my instances, because I'm a short dude and I perform with dudes that are like 6 feet or 5'6" and up. Like, my favorite comment is from the audience member. Any audience member is like they thought when they come up.
They thought you were taller.
They thought I was taller. Yeah. They like because I dance taller than I am. So it's all about like the energy you bring, not and along with obviously knowing the choreography and executing it well. But
and I get that not even like on stage. Like you know I'll have like
it's
I'll hang
big
up.
Dick energy.
I do have that. the energy and the actual dick. Anyway.
I've seen it. I choked on it. Okay, maybe I should add that part. But,
like, that whole, like, you know, I thought you were taller compliment, because I'm 4'11". If you thought you were short.
Oh, yeah.
I'm shorter.
I keep thinking, now I think you're taller.
I'm 4'11". I have, like, you know, I'm not, like, the biggest, like, extrovert or whatever. But when I'm with my friends, I get, like, fairly energetic. When I'm comfortable with people, I get, like, fairly energetic. And when I do that, like, people... You know, and then I think there was another person that was around like your height, maybe, or just maybe just slightly shorter.
Was
and everyone's like,
handsome?
Oh, she's a girl.
Oh, was she equally handsome?
Yes. I don't know. And like she was about, like she's around your height, and people thought we were the same height. And some people, and then there was a smaller group of people that thought she was shorter than me, because she was quieter. She was quieter, and then when she walks into the room, she like will walk into the room, sit in a corner, and read. I walked into that same room, sat in a corner, and read. But like, I guess apparently the way I walk in and walk through was just like, well, I was pissed off most of the time because this was during college. So
yeah. So I mean, how you show up in your I guess your body language.
I know how to walk with a purpose.
Like how you show up in, with your body language, into power body language and power, like it will really help with the perspective of like how people.
And Lady Gaga's short too. She's energy. Too.
So yeah, I mean, yeah, that's right. I thought
Ariana Grande short too. She's short too.
This like aside from them performing on heels and platform boots, which I will never know, and that's
I tried
mad,
it
mad props to them. But they're dancing like they're 7 feet.
Yeah, they looked like. I mean, they were also like up front, so they looked like they were about the same height as the dancers.
Yeah, they forced perspective.
I know about Force Perspective because I guess I was always up front.
So if you guys enjoyed today's episode of Emeroy TV of reacting to everything, well, a good chunk of things on Rain On Me. If you guys like it, make sure you hit like, subscribe, share this with friends who you think might benefit from it. Really hit that like button because it'll help with the channel. And, you know, check out all the Lady Gaga stuff that she's going to be releasing with.
Chromatica out May 29th.
Yep. So I'm a huge... admire and appreciate, and I appreciate her work, and as a performer, especially after watching her documentary, man, the hustle and the work.
Oh yeah, and through the pain.
Yeah,
always evolving. She's always changing and adapting evolving
that's
with the times to either get ahead of it, like she's, like, it looks like she's trying to keep up with the times, but like she's doing that and also like taking it to another level to get ahead of it.
Yeah, I think feel like she's being truly authentic to herself, not trying to be what it is. She's keep paying attention to it, I feel like, but she's like owning.
She always has her like, you know, finger on the pulse spin. And everything. But
so she's, and that's what I love. And then she's still reinventing and doing something fresh, and excited for it. I love this type of music. It's very housey and upbeat, dancey, because I can get down to it. And it's not, and for me as a dancer, it doesn't feel like it's stuck to one specific style.
Yeah,
I feel like I can break to it. I feel like I can lock to it. I can house to it. All right, so that's it. Thanks for watching this episode of Emeroy TV, and I will see you guys next time. Peace.